Looking for Diamond City? Just follow the signs.
Hey, who's there?
Sorry, just doing my job.
Ooh, just doing your job. Protecting Diamond City means keeping me out, is that it? Oh, look, it's the scary reporter. Boo! You. You want into Diamond City, right?
I just got here, but yeah.
Shh. Play along.
What's that? You said you're a trader up from Quincy? You have enough supplies to keep the general store stocked for a whole month? You hear that, Danny? You gonna open the gate and let us in, or are you gonna be the one talking to crazy Myrna about losing out on all the supply?
Jeez, all right. I need to make it personal, Piper. Give me a minute.
Better head inside quick before old Danny catches on to the bluff.
Diamond City. What is it?
Oh, the Green Jewel? She's a sight. Everyone who's anyone in the Commonwealth is from here, settled here, got kicked out of here. A big wall, some power, working plumbing, schools, and some security goons are what make Diamond City the big monster it is. Oh, love it or hate it. You'll see for yourself soon enough. Let's go.
Piper, who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing slanderer. The level of dishonesty in that paper of yours. I'll have that printer scrap for parts.
Mr. McDonough, tyrant mayor shuts down the press. Why don't we ask the newcomer? You support the news? Because the mayor's threatening to throw free speech in the dumpster.
Newspapers just like to stir up trouble.
Oh, I didn't mean to bring you into this argument, miss. No. No, no. You look like Diamond City material. Welcome to the great Green Jewel of the Commonwealth. Safe, happy, a fine place to come. Spend your money. Settle down. Don't let this muckraker here tell you otherwise, all right?
This hasn't been the friendliest welcome.
She's got you there, McDonough. Guess not everyone gets won over by that shark smile of yours.
No. Was there anything particular you came to our city for?
What is this place, anyway?
Why, this is the safest place in all the Commonwealth, with the strongest community and highest standards of living available. We have stores, doctors, schools, power, running water, and the wall as our sacred protector. You'll learn more about the wall soon, I'm sure. But I was talking about you. Come on now, what brought you all the way out here?
I'm trying to find someone.
Trying to find someone? Who?
Who would I talk to about finding a missing person?
Well, whatever you do, don't bother going to Diamond City Security for help.
Don't listen to her. Well, I'm afraid that our security team can't follow every case that comes through. I'm confident that you can find help here. Diamond City has every conceivable service known to man. One of our great citizens can surely find the time to help you.
A mayor of a great city must know everyone. Who can help me?
Well, there is one private citizen, Nick Valentine, a detective of sorts who specializes in tracking people down, usually for debts or whatnot. No, I have to get going. I'm sorry, Diamond City Security doesn't have time to help, but I'm sure Mr. Valentine charges a reasonable fee.
This is ridiculous. I want the truth, McDonough. What's the real reason security always shrivels away when talk of missing persons comes?
I've had enough of this, Piper. From now on, consider you and that little sister of yours on notice.
Yeah, keep talking, McDonough. That's all you're good for. I'm impressed. Not everyone can claw information out of McDonough's tight-fisted hands. Why don't you stop by my office after you see Valentine? I think I just found my next story.
Thank you. Head on inside.
So, you're that traitor Piper was talking about. Something tells me she's pulled the wool over my eyes again. Am I right?
I wasn't lying. I got a whole supply train coming in tomorrow.
Is that right? No bull? Well, if that's the case, let me put a down payment on some parts for the gate. Here you go. Anyway, welcome to Diamond City and all that. I gotta get back to work.
Hey, kiddo. How are the paper sales?
Well, the presses are getting overloaded. That motor is going to go soon if we don't replace it.
You've been saying that for weeks and the old girl still keeps cranking. Stop worrying so much. I gotta head into the office. You start whistling if you see any angry politicians coming our way.
Why? Is something wrong? Piper? Who's really in control of Diamond City? Read the public.
Anyone is one of those things. It's that secretary of his, her and her perfect hair.
Mm-hmm.
The mayor's secretary. Come on, Ma. I cut her hair myself, and I know human hair.
That's just it, Johnny. You wouldn't be able to tell the difference. If you
there's
Nick
a bar in the old theater district that's paraders only. A combat zone.
I'd stay clear if I was you.
Got too much dirt in that hair? Get it trimmed. You won't regret it.
Around here, we call your haircut the scab special. Little flecks of blood, give it the personal touch. You should think about getting a trim.
I'll think about it.
Feel free to come back anytime.
Don't let the stress of life kill you. Relax with some cans.
Prescriptions filled right here. Anything you need.
Did you say something about drugs?
That's right. All the chems you need to fill out your lifestyle. Balance you out. Everyone here buys from me. Sometimes security needs a little psycho, or an engineer needs some Mentats. And heck, Rad X is plain universal.
I don't need anything.
You do your thing.
Diamond City Surplus. Everything you need.
Don't be caught dead. Protection from Commonwealth weaponry.
You? I don't know you. Just keep your distance.
You're acting all kinds of crazy.
I am not crazy. I read the paper. I know the synths are here, walking among us. So wait, are you telling me you're human?
Synth? What's a synth?
A synth, as in synthetic person. Those things the Institute makes. Look real, with hair and sweat and blood and everything. So, are you human or not?
No, I'm Jangles, the moon monkey.
That's just what a synth would do, ducking the question. We don't serve your kind here.
No skull in the league, it would stand a swatter.
You're that new girl, right?
The new girl?
Word kind of travels fast in Diamond City. What can I say? Name's Arturo Rodriguez. If you need protection, let's talk.
So you know weapons, huh?
Listen, I can sell you guns, swords, whatever. And they'll keep you alive for sure. But the real secret is in the mods. The little personal touches. Install a scope, expand the clip size, whatever. You spend time with your gear, and you'll have the right answer to every problem. Anyway, let's get back to you and what kind of protection you need.
Not today.
All right.
Thank you.
address the subject that is on everyone's mind. And that is the disgusting article Piper has written. Diamond City has stood united for over 150 years. And what keeps us united are two things. First is the great green guardian behind me, the wall, our protector and our savior from the filth of the outside. And second is our faith and trust in each other. The faith and trust that has given us prosperity, security, and education for every citizen. And while the paper might point their fingers at synths and other ghost stories to drive us apart, we will not betray this sacred trust. Now, I want everyone to hear these next words very carefully. I am not a synth. I am the same flesh and blood boy who grew up on these streets, who was born in a shack just down the waterfront to Martha and Patrick McDonough. And I will not abandon my city due to the heinous allegations of the press. God bless this city. God bless the wall.
His ties. Oh, Nick. Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
I didn't come here to get brushed off.
Well, you can take a seat and wait for the next Armageddon. Because the detective ain't coming back. He's gone missing.
Do you have any idea how I could find him?
He disappeared working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does. Please, hurry.
Bobby, if I might bend your ear for a moment.
What's up, Codsworth?
So gracious, Mom. I do appreciate it. I've always had such admiration for you and your family, ever since the day my visual senses were first switched on. You and Sir, so good with young Sean, and so trusting of me to look after such a newborn bundle of joy. It just warms my nuclear core. So, you can imagine the distress I felt when the bombs fell. I searched, but found no evidence of your death, Dick scanned, just to make sure I wasn't malfunctioning. But the news of Sir and young Sean. Believe me when I say it takes a true hero to live through that.
You're getting pretty mushy for a robot.
Mushy, perhaps, but completely forthright. In such a bleak world as this, think of all you've witnessed and all you've done. In my 200 years, I've seen it tear good men and women apart. But you, Mum, you have remained the very model of what humanity should aspire to be.
Enough, Codsworth.
All right, all right. I have said my piece and meant every word. Take it as you will. But I do still believe if anyone can help the Commonwealth regain its former glory, it's you. Now, not another word. I stand firm in my belief.
Kyle, me! I'm not a sin!
Don't move, Synth. What have you done with the real Riley? Where's my brother?
I swear, I'm not a Synth. Don't shoot, for God's sakes, we're family!
Put the gun down, now!
He's a Synth! He'll kill us all!
Kyle, no!
Okay, show's over. There are no Synths in Diamond City, hear me? Just you folks and your damn paranoia.
Officer?
I need you to step away, Scabber.
There a problem, officer?
Oh, don't even start with me. I got a dead body in the middle of the damn street. Now follow orders and get out of here.
Hey, Solomon.
You gotta accept life on its terms, you know? Something bad happens, just say yes to it.
Eddie can't learn to relax, huh, Darcy?
Shut up. I don't come here to talk about Paul.
You there! I haven't seen you in here before. Why don't you make yourself useful and buy me a drink or something?
You don't look like you need another drink.
Aren't you all high and mighty, then? Why don't you get lost so I can drink in peace?
Lighten up, Darcy. This isn't your own private bar, no matter what you might think. Anyway, I got a bar to run. Ordering?
So, is this your place?
That's right. Owner, bartender, sympathetic ear. I try to provide a little oasis from the hardships of life. Name's Cook, by the way. Henry Cook. Let me know if I can get you anything.
Just browsing for now.
Later then.
Hey there.
Why, hello there. So lovely to see more young people up here in the stands. We're all so, well, old.
Well, hello there. Another one of the poor and stupid of Diamond City come begging for table scraps?
I don't beg, you stuck-up old bat.
Fine. Go ahead and pretend you're someone important. I'm getting bored. Why don't you make yourself scarce?
Who are you, anyway?
Anne Codman. Of the Codman family? Of the upper stands? If you haven't heard of us, that just shows how unimportant you are. Now, were you leaving or not?
Bitch.
What did you say? Oh, whatever. I'm done talking to you. Hey.
Miss Furiosa.
Hi.
If I wanted to talk to you, you'd know it.
Wait there.
Will do!
Hey.
Can I be of service?
Hey.
You just walked right
into the stones,
didn't you? I like your stones.
Thing. Henry's missing too. Which is what makes me really worried about Paul.
I don't know anything about it.
Okay. Sorry to bother you.
I'll keep up the good work, okay? We need more people like you.
Thanks. It's good to know. Remember to support your local Minutemen.
You're a real hero. Not many around these days. This is for you. It's nothing much, but I hope it'll help the cause.
No. Hey, Takahashi.
Nani shimasu ka?
Tell me a joke.
Nani shimasu ka?
Yes. What kind of interview is this gonna be?
I ask you who you are, get your opinion on life out there, and maybe load up a few tough questions and keep it interesting. What do you say?
All right, Piper. I'm in.
Good. Let's get down to business. So, I know you're from a vault. How would you describe your time on the inside?
Normal. Nothing out of the ordinary.
Normalcy is a bit of a relative concept in the Commonwealth, but... okay. I can work with that.
I'm telling you, joining Skinny Malone's crew was the best decision we've ever made. Look at this place.
I still say Malone's weak. We caught that detective snooping around, and what does he do? Locks him up. Like he ain't got the balls to just kill him.
Well, don't let his new girl hear that. She'll start swinging that bat of hers at your face until there ain't no face left. What was that? Huh? Wait a minute.
What was that?
I see you!
Come on! held your own there, Blue.
Malone's gonna have you cut for charge.
I got a question. Why the hell would anyone build a vault out of a subway station? This place is like the opposite of airtight.
Because they weren't planning to use it, you moron. We used to pull this kind of con all the time back before the war. Get a bunch of union boys to work some construction job that would go nowhere. Keep everyone on payroll.
What?
Hey, you! I don't know who you are, but we got 3 minutes before they realize muscles for brains ain't coming back. Get this door open!
Gotta love the irony of the reverse damsel in distress scenario. Question is, why did our heroine risk life and limb for an old private eye?
I'm tracking a murderer. The bastard who shot my husband, took my baby. I don't even have a clue who he is or where he's gone.
So you need a little angel of vengeance, huh? Well, I don't usually go after blood money, but I guess I can make an exception. I've been cooped up in here for weeks. Turns out the runaway daughter I came here to find wasn't kidnapped. She's Skinny Malone's new flame. And she's got a mean streak. Anyway.
Hell yeah.
This door's on the fritz. Let me see if I can get it open. Almost got it. There we are. Hell of a lot easier to do when the lock isn't on the other side.
One more obituary!
There you go! My arm!
Clean house. More stairs? Who built this damn vault? A fitness instructor? Playing hide and seek? Won't underestimate us again. Skinny Malone and the rest of his boys are waiting for us somewhere. The name's, ironic, but don't let that fool you. He's dangerous. Another locked door. Shouldn't be too hard. Okay, I got it. But I hear big fat footsteps on the other side. Once we step through this door, get ready for anything.
Nikki, what are you doing? You come into my house, shoot up my guys? You have any idea how much this is gonna set me back?
I wouldn't be here if it weren't for your two-timing dame, Skinny. You ought to tell her to write home more often.
Oh, poor little Valentine. Ashamed you got beat up by a girl. I'll run back home to death, shall I?
Should've left it alone, Nikki. This ain't the old neighborhood. In this vault, I'm king of the castle. You hear me? And I ain't letting some private dick shut us down now that I finally got a good thing going.
I told you we should've just killed him! But then you had to get all sentimental. All that stupid crap about the old times.
Darla, I'm handling this. Skinny Malone's always got things under control.
Oh, yeah? Then what's this lady doing here, huh? Valentine must have brought her here to rub us all out.
Skinny's no good for you, Darla. You put a bullet in him, I just might let you go.
Wow. You're a bad girl, ain't ya? Sorry, babe. But this is the end for us. And for you.
You
double-crossing Maul. Teach me to fall for a great set of legs.
He's lighter or heavier with all those holes in him. Well, the bullets probably add a few ounces. Good night, sweet prince. Here's to all the old days. Let's get out of here. There's a service ladder that should take us right to the surface. Look at that Commonwealth sky. Never thought anything so naturally ominous could end up looking so inviting. Thanks for getting me out. How did you know where to find me, anyway? Not many people knew where I went.
Just... what are you, Nick?
You really don't know? I'm a synth. Synthetic man. All the parts, minus a few red blood cells. I got built, I got old, I got tossed. Then I opened up that little agency in Diamond City, and turns out people have plenty of problems to solve. Now, you mentioned something about a missing person. No trace of where they've gone.
I want you to come to my office in Diamond City. Give me all the details. Besides, I think you've earned a chance to sit down and clear your head. Traveling in the Commonwealth as long as I have, you learn a few things. These old buildings and alleyways give you a lot of opportunities to hide if things get bad, but that goes both ways. Always keep your eyes out and your head on a swivel. Things can go from calm to deadly in a heartbeat. Diamond City is as close to safe as you can get in these parts. Security keeps the perimeter under control, but it's always a struggle. Despite the mayor's bragging, it really is the most secure settlement around. Even if it comes with a few uptight guards.
Every cap we agreed to for finding him. Plus a little something extra.
All right, let's get down to business. Take a seat. Make yourself comfortable. When you're trying to find someone who's gone missing, the devil is in the details. Tell me everything you can.
We're looking for my baby, Sean. He's less than a year old. Why would anyone take him?
Good question. Why your family in particular, and why an infant? Someone would be taking on all of his care, and a baby needs a lot of it. What else can you tell me?
There was a man and a woman. They didn't say much, but I remember they called me the backup.
Well, that confirms it. This isn't a random kidnapping. Whoever took your kid had an agenda. There's a lot of groups in the Commonwealth that take people.
Who are the gunners?
High-end mercenaries. No job too brutal. They're in the...
Nice hat. You think raiders might have done this?
I honestly doubt it. They can barely organize themselves, let alone pull off something this complicated.
Super mutants. What are they?
Big, green... muscles on muscles. In other words, hard to miss.
So you think this institute is responsible?
Well, they're the boogeymen of the Commonwealth. Something goes wrong, everyone blames them. Easy to see why. Those early model synths of theirs strip whole towns for parts, killing everything in their way. Then you got the newer models, good as human, that infiltrate cities and pull strings from the shadows. Worst of all, no one knows why they do it, what their plan is, or where they are. Not even me. And I'm a synth myself. A discarded prototype, anyway.
Don't lie to me, Nick. You're one of them. They made you.
Yeah, I've heard it all before. You're a freak. You've got something to hide. Blah, blah, blah. But the truth is, people smart enough to build something like me are smart enough to cover their tracks. And arrogant enough to throw their unwanted trash into the Commonwealth to fend for itself.
You're a prototype?
As far as I know. Never seen any other synth like myself. There's the older ones that are dumb as rocks and all metal.
Either way, I need to find Sean.
You're right. The speculation is getting us off track. Let's focus on what you saw. What did these kidnappers look like?
One of them came right up to me. Bald head, scar across his left eye.
Wait. It couldn't be. Ellie, what notes do we have about the Kellogg case?
The description matches. Bald head, scar, reputation for dangerous mercenary work, but no one knows who his employer is.
And he bought a house here in town, right? And he had a kid with him, didn't he?
Oh. Yeah, that's right. The house in the abandoned West Stands. The boy with him was around 10 years old.
There's no way that could be Sean.
Yeah, big difference between an infant and a 10-year-old, but that doesn't mean we're on the wrong track. He could have a son of his own. Or maybe he's turned kidnapping into a bad habit. In any event, they both vanished a while back. No trace. Let's you and I take a walk over to Kellogg's last known address. See if we can snoop out where he went.
Security doesn't really go to that part of town, but you two should still be careful.
I always am.
Let's take a look around. Kellogg must have left something behind. Place seems small to you. I think a guy like Kellogg would think big.
Gwinnett's stout beer, 44 caliber bullets, cigars, San Francisco sunlights.
Interesting brand. Won't lead us anywhere on its own, though.
We'll never find him.
Damn it, drop the doom and gloom act. We can work through this. What about dog meat? A Commonwealth mutt like him can track a scent for miles. Why don't you go fetch him and let him have a whiff? See if he picks up the trail. Before you head out, I know this is personal business. You have to face Kellogg on your own. Just say so.
Any words of wisdom?
Kellogg really is the one who kidnapped your son. And he's dangerous. But so are you. You don't need to be afraid of him or anything else the Commonwealth throws at you.
I want you with me on this, Nick.
All right. Let's get that bastard. This is your show from here on out, okay? You say jump, I'll say how high.
Dog meat. Get the scent, boy. Got something, boy.
San Francisco sunlights. Kellogg's preferred brand, all right. Okay, boy. Let's track him.
Tracking known mercenary. Exercise extreme caution.
Just tell me where Kellogg went, tin can.
Identity of assailant, Kellogg.
We're still on track. Hopefully he's not much further. dog meets stubborn. You'll find our man.
We're at the old army base. Is he hiding out here? Is this the place? Huh? Is he in here, boy?
I knew dog meat would sniff our man out. Let's you and I take it from here. Give our four-legged friend a break.
And my old friend, the frozen TV dinner. Last time we met, you were cozying up to the peas and apple cobbler. Never expected you to come knocking on my door. Gave you 50-50 odds of making it to Diamond City. After that, figured the Commonwealth would chew you up like jerky.
Movement detected. You're stealthy.
Guts and determination. It's admirable. But you are in over your head in ways you can't possibly comprehend.
Remember, Kellogg's a professional. He won't make it easy.
You made it. I'm just up ahead. My synths are standing down. Let's talk.
So, here we are. Funny, huh?
You murdered my husband. Took my baby. You're a dead man.
Your husband? It was a regrettable accident. Still, this world, this life, you've seen it. Pain, suffering. Death is its only escape. But don't worry. Sean's fine. Maybe a little older than you expected, huh? But I can't give him to you, because he ain't here.
God damn it, you mercenary motherfucker! Where is my son?
What's the cliche? So close, but yet so far away? That's Sean. Your son is exactly where he belongs. He's home. In the Institute. But don't worry. You'll die knowing he's safe and happy. A bit older than you expected, but ah well. At least he's in a loving home.
No, that's not true. It can't be. I've come so far.
Yes, you have. And believe it or not, I'm actually kind of sorry you wasted your time. In another life, you probably wouldn't have been a good mother. But here, in this terrible reality, you just don't get that chance. But I think we've been talking long enough. We both know how this has to end. So, you ready?
I'm gonna make you suffer. You were barely human.
All the intel this place can hide. Wonder what Kellogg was up to before we dropped in on him. Giving us any bull. Your son really is on the inside. Even I don't know where the Institute is, and they built me.
Bullshit! You're a synth, Valentine. Tell me what you know.
You want to know the truth? The sad thing is, I have no idea. None of us do. You think they'd cut me loose if I had something on them?
I don't know anything, Nick.
Look at me. I'm trash. They threw me in the junk pile ages ago. Just another discarded prototype. Didn't exactly leave me the house keys. We're in the weeds here. Time to take a step back, bring in some fresh eyes. Only person I know willing to snoop up the Institute's tail feathers is Piper, the reporter in Diamond City. I say we head her way. talk this through.
It's over. I've lost him.
Look, I know it feels like a shot in the heart, but this case isn't closed. Not while I'm on it.
Tell me about the Minutemen.
You know that group you rescued and conquered? Far as I know, they're the last Minutemen left in the Commonwealth. They used to be a volunteer army, dedicated to protecting friends, family, and neighbors. Sounds soft, but they were a real thing at one point.
That Brotherhood airship is hard to miss.
Yeah, the Brotherhood of Steel doesn't do subtle. From what I've heard, they take whatever they want. Especially if it's high-tech. They just might have the muscle to give the Institute a run for their money, but they're... Let's just say they have their own agenda.